people.
Joining me now is Congressman Mike Quigley. He represents the 5th District in Illinois, Democratic Congressman. Great to have you with me. Let me start by asking you what you've heard from constituents. You noted on Twitter you had more than 800 calls about this policy dealing with folks on the U.S.-Mexico border. What are you hearing from constituents, and what are you telling them about what Congress might do to correct this problem?
Yeah, that number is over 3,000 contacts with my office now. After this discussion, I'm heading up to a rally in the middle of my district where kids and families will be there. It is people who are ashamed, disgusted, and extraordinarily angry at what's happening. I had a former Marine who talked about his post-traumatic stress and actions in Vietnam, where U.S. soldiers were forced to separate Vietnamese families from their children, and how that still impacts him. But we're doing that right now, and the dramatic impact it's having on our image and the rest of the world is a real shame.
You've written a letter along with several of your colleagues to the Department of Homeland Security, the Department of Health and Human Services as well, with some basic questions here about how this reunification is going to work, about where these children are, among other things. What have you heard back, if anything? How much confusion is there still on Capitol Hill?
There is absolutely no plan for reuniting these families. And honestly, even if their heart was in the right place, I'm not sure how they would do that. There's extraordinary communication issues. These are very young children. They're not going to be able to help in this process, in identification. And we're now talking on Capitol Hill. We're hearing from the administration. They're going to put up to 20,000 people in military establishments, in forts. Apparently, we think these kids are so dangerous, they need to be, we need to use tanks and guns. It absolutely makes no sense. At this point in time, we've orphaned thousands of children with no plan for reuniting them. I don't see how they could possibly get this done. It's an extraordinary disgrace for our country.
Congressman, we were talking a few moments ago about the politics of all of this and what Republicans in particular, your Republican colleagues, have heard from this president, from the White House. Let me just read one tweet from the president to you here. We must maintain a strong southern border. We cannot allow our country to be overrun by illegal immigrants as the Democrats tell their phony stories of sadness and grief, hoping it will help them in the elections. Obama and others had the same pictures and did nothing about it. What do you make about the of the way in which this White House is infusing politics into this?
Yeah, it's using kids we've now made orphans as political bargaining chips. I think there were opportunities this last week for bipartisan cooperation to show the President of the United States this isn't the country that we are. Unfortunately, my friends across the aisle, the Republicans, they couldn't even pass a bill in their own caucus. They passed the Goodlatte bill, which was far more conservative, and they had what they phrased as a compromise Ryan bill, and they couldn't even put it on the floor. So I think it's the lead from the administration that makes this worse. But as Democrats, we're willing to work together. There are bills on the that should be on the floor that could solve this problem tomorrow. Then we would begin the process of trying to reunite these families.
It wouldn't be a Saturday morning if we didn't get a tweet from the president about the Russia investigation, him calling it a witch hunt. In fact, he did that this morning as well. I want to draw your attention here to a new poll. CNN looking at approval for Robert Mueller and the investigation that he's conducting. We see approval of those surveyed has gone down from 48% in March to 41% here in June. How worried are you at this point? You sit on the House Intelligence Committee about that investigation running its course, about Bob Mueller being protected as he continues and concludes his investigation.
Yeah, as Mr. Mueller took his position, he received bipartisan kudos all across the board. He was an extraordinarily well-respected war hero. Who's doing an amazing job. He needs to be allowed to continue this investigation. I do remember that when Watergate took place, from the date of the break-in to the day that the president left office was 28 months, and that was with a Democratic caucus. The American public has to be much more patient than I suspect that they want to be. This is a far more complicated investigation, and I believe a far more important political and criminal investigation than Watergate ever was, because it involved a foreign adversary. So all I can do is stress with the American public, just the great job that Mr. Mueller is doing, the stresses we have faced facing hand-in-glove cooperation to obstruct the investigation from the House Republicans on the Intel Committee, working with the White House to make sure the truth doesn't come out.
The gentleman from Chicago, Congressman Mike Quigley.